Singaporeans and residents of Punggol East, welcome back. Today's issue is something very important. Punggol East has a lot of young couples who are living there. But young couples have a very, very, very unique problem. They have all just come out from universities or graduated from polytechnics. They have still got student loans to pay. And young couples are saying, we want to get married. Yes, there are 60,000 and more singles of marriageable age in Singapore, but they can't afford even a basic housing. And these emails that have been coming in, from you are now waking us as a whole to this big problem in Singapore. We want our fertility rate to go up. We want young couples to marry. But if they can't even afford a home, if they can't even afford to have a roof over their heads, how will they be able to start a family? And not just the young couples, there are also many Singaporeans who are in the low income bracket. Mr. Desmond Lim is again with us today to answer these important questions on how, with the escalating housing prices and with the cost of living going up. Mr. Lim, question for you. How are you going to help Singaporeans tackle these two issues? Number one, of housing escalating prices, and most importantly, the cost of living. Thank you.
The cost of owning a home in Singapore seems to be a more difficult task. As the years go by, look at the rental cost for business, renters for homes, and the figure of what HDB flats are going for. Couples are taking longer to tie the knots, let alone embark in family planning. The first reason I have touched on in my earlier message about the lack of childcare supports. Now, the other problems couples face is owning a home. So many young adults in my walkabouts have echoed the same message that they delay getting married because they find it hard to save up in time to buy a home. So the years go by and the marriage is perceived as an expensive and long-term goal. How many of you have heard friends or relatives share the views that it is more affordable to live elsewhere, where homes are within reachable standards? Even business owners echo sentiments of high rental costs. So many small to medium companies struggle to maintain day-to-day operating costs alongside high rentals that dilute profitability in the long run. Added the stress to maintain the local versus overseas talents within the setups seems to reduce the viability of running a business in Singapore. My solutions. The governments may want to consider pegging home price to the median salary of an age group that is between 20 to 30 for first-time home buyers. And even if they are beyond the age of 30, this will give young couples a push to plan for the next stage with confidence. This will in turn improve the fertility rates if marriages are sealed early. Make it more affordable and attainable, give them the push to take the lead and move into a new phase in life with certainty. This will not affect property price at large, as the scheme will be applicable to that specific groups and the resale of these units will go back to HDB. Secondly, reduction of property price should not just be for homes, but businesses as well. To encourage young entrepreneurs and new setup, make in Singapore brands. Then the government has to give a leg up to this group. Starting a business at a low startup cost with a lower renters could provide them with a means of long-term sustenance. As such, rental for business should be kept depending on locality and space. Have special tax rebates for landlords renting to this business if they work their renters within the cap, or sign long-term lease with this business. So the incentive for landlords are there, and for the business, it gives them room to breathe in the foundation years in operations.
Thank you, Mr. Lim. I think this idea that he has now suggested to help control the escalating prices of housing and also the cost of living is a very unique idea. I think we need to look deeper into it, and these kind of good proposals have to be raised in Parliament. You have to vote this Saturday wisely for SDA. You have to vote for Desmond Lim because we need your empowerment to be able to fight for your issues. We are an alliance. We are not just one small party alone. We have a team of people working for you, coming out with the best proposals, the best ideas, the best ways to present it to make sure our lives as Singaporeans become better, better and better. Do your part too. If you have ideas, suggestions or even questions, write into singaporeelections@gmail.com and we'll be more than happy to address them. Once again, I want to thank Mr. Desmond Lim. I'm very sure this dedicated local and determined leader is going to be our voice in Parliament. Vote for Desmond Lim. Vote for SDA. Mr. AL writes in and he says, my little tribute to the small guy whom everyone seems to be making fun of. He continues, he says, 14 years is a very long time, but I know that for 14 years, Mr. Lim was serving in the Potong Pasir Town Council, and the experience that he has will go and serve the residents of Punggol East exceptionally. Mr. AL continues and he says, 14 years is a long time. Many of us would not even give 14 minutes to causes we believe in. So don't diss Desmond. He has every right to contest in this by-election. He may not speak as well as me or you, or he may also not be as politically astute as you feel he should be. But it is quite evident from his years of work that he does want to serve, and indeed, he is the most qualified of the four choices. LCH says, thank you, Desmond Lim, for standing up for this election. You come across as a very sincere, as a very honest, and I feel very uneasy and unfair when some people attack you on Facebook and in other media. Realize, Desmond, you are not my brother. Neither are you my brother-in-law, nor are you my relative. But I still stand up to say you and the work that you are doing and the work that your party is doing is fully appreciated by all of us here. And I urge all Singaporeans to give you a fair chance, Mr. LCH.